Wind produces, and they do not reflect the views and opinion of Boston Praise Radio, its staff, or management.
Kingdom greetings and God's richest blessings be multiplied to you and to your beloved family. You're now tuned into Healing Our Lands live interactive worldwide broadcast here on the Boston Praise Radio and TV network. I am your host, Pastor Franklin Wendell Hobbs. I'll be with you tonight through till 9 p.m. We're on live every Sunday night, 7 p.m. through to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Monday through Friday, we begin at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Monday, Thursday, and Friday, concluding at 7 p.m., Tuesday and Wednesday, concluding at 6 p.m. to make way for other live programming. And we come back every Saturday night and host what's called the Church of the Midnight Hour from 11 p.m. through to Sunday morning, 6 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're so grateful for the generous support of Caleb International Ministry and its Ezra Institute of Apologetics that affords us the opportunity to simulcast on WRCA 1330 a.m. every Saturday night, 12 a.m. through to Sunday morning, 6 a.m. We're excited about us fastly approaching launching our FM signal, 102.9 FM WBPGLP are the call letters. And so we solicit your prayers. We solicit your continuing to spread the word, as well as your continued financial support. You can go to our webpage, www.bostonpraiseradio.tv, and click the donate button to give your tax-deductible donation to our ministry, as well as you can purchase. I've got t-shirts, a couple of them left. They're $20 to the commemorative t-shirts, limited edition of this particular iteration of our growth, with the call letters and the address on the back of the shirt, as well as the logo on the front of the shirt on these blue Boston Praise Radio and TV Network t-shirts. We also have a few pieces left of our brother T. Michael Thomas's copper jewelry that is like $30 minimal donation. They're beautiful earrings and a couple of bracelets here that are 100% pure copper, handcrafted by our brother T. Michael Thomas. And so again, they're beautiful pieces, and we're just asking for a donation of a minimum of $30 to be able to have your beautiful handcrafted copper pieces from our own brother T. Michael Thomas's The People's Academy. And so you can also stop by the studio. We've got a jar here that you can drop your loose change, or dollars, or in. So there are many ways that you can be able to help us financially to be able to launch our new FM signal and to be on the air and to be able to have all the full vision of the Boston Praise Radio and TV network to come to fruition. But we're excited about where we are. So again, we can solicit your continued prayers and financial support and communication with other people to tune into the broadcast, to support our broadcast, to be able to consider having advertising your business, your ministry, and or being a sponsor or a benefactor to our ministry. 617-282-0685, that's the number to call live on the air. You can call Healing Our Land Ministry at 617-435-2066. And we're going to go to some music. We typically open up our broadcast with music by Pastor Frida Battle and the Temple Worshippers. The song is Here Is Our Praise, which is the title cut to her second to last project. Incidentally, tonight is the second Sunday of the month. And as it stands, our sister elder Heidi Lewis Ivy will be with us tonight, 9 p.m. through to 10 p.m. following Healing Our Lands broadcast. She is on every second Saturday, every second Sunday of the month from 9 p.m. through to 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time via www.bostonpraiseradio.tv, simulcasting on the Roku Television Network. And tonight, the Massachusetts Association of Minority Law Enforcement Officers, otherwise known as MAMLEO, will be following her from 10 p.m. through to 11 p.m. Stay tuned as we have, with this growth, we've got a lot of changes happening in terms of scheduling, so stay locked to be able to hear the updates of programmings, when they'll be on, and as we are embracing this exponential growth season here at the Boston Praise Radio and TV Network. Again, we solicit your prayers, your patience, and your support. Without further ado, Pastor Frida Battle and the Temple Worshippers, this song's entitled Here Is Our Praise. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
sing it again, worshipers. Blessing.
Blessing and glory.
Wisdom.
Wisdom and power.
Belongs.
Belongs to our Lord and King.
And all of the praises.
All of the praises.
Every acknowledgement.
Every acknowledgement. Belongs to our Lord and King.
Here is our praise.
Give it all to you.
Our Father. we bless you. Come on, worshipers, one more time.
Hallelujah. 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 Here is our praise that everything that has breath praise the Lord as God inhabits the praises of his people. When we give God a sacrifice of praise, he literally inhabits our praises and he ushers us into worship. We can't praise God and be depressed at the same time, because when we praise him, he literally gets off his throne, inhabits our very being, and he shifts the atmosphere, changes our perspective, and he ushers us into worship, understanding our all-powerful God, our all-knowing God, who's every place, the past, the present, and the future. His love is unconditional, and I thank God that he knows the plan that he has for each and every one of our lives. It is to give us a hope, it's to give us a future, and it's to bring us to an expected end. And we know that all things are working together for the good of us who love God and are called according to his purpose. The difficult things, the painful things, the things we don't understand, the things out of our control, we must pray to God for the peace to accept the things that we have no power over, to be able to change the things that we do have the ability to be able to impact, and the wisdom to be able to discern between the two, trusting, knowing that our relationship with Jesus Christ will ultimately, he will lead us and he will guide us into all truth. I'm so grateful for God's angels that stay in charge over us, that take protect us, that lead us and guide us. When we are authentic in our relationship with Christ, he will lead and guide us into all truth. I thank God for that. We overcome only by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. I want to go to some more music. And again, we'd love to hear from you, your song dedication, your praise report, your prayer request, to ask your question, communicate what's on your heart, what's on your mind, or simply just to say hello. But let everything that has breath praise the Lord as God inhabits the praises of his people. This is the foundation scripture for the ministry of healing our land and my life. It's 2 Chronicles 7:14, and Daryl Coley singing it. And the scripture says, if my people who are called by my name would humble ourselves and pray and seek God's face and turn from our respective wicked ways, that God will hear from heaven the sacrifices exclusively acceptable to him, which are a broken spirit, a contrite heart. He will forgive our sin and he will heal our land. Daryl Coley coming to you with 2 Chronicles 7:14. 617-282-0685. www.bostonpraiseradio.tv.
If my people who are called by my name, would humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their I'll hear.
Jesus promised if we'd humble ourselves and pray and seek God's face and turn from our wicked ways, he will hear from heaven, forgive our sin, and he will heal our land. Pastor Frieda Battle coming to you with a song entitled Hallelujah. Sister Tina Lee, who's just blessed us with her presence, tuning in from Boston, and she's communicating greetings to all from your sister, my friend Tina Lee. God bless you, sis. We love you to life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. That's the universal praise that means celebrate God. Halal, a Hebrew word meaning to celebrate. Jah, meaning God. Celebrate God. Hallelujah. In every language, that's the same. I think that's amazing that no matter what nation, tongue we come from, we praise God in the same way with that praise. Celebrate God. Hallelujah. I'm going to go to some more music, and this psalm is the Mississippi Mass Choir. The psalm's entitled, If I Be Lifted Up, God Said, I Will Draw All Mankind Unto Me.
I'm trying.
says, he said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord.
Somebody on your row and look at somebody and say, neighbor,
neighbor,
if you didn't come to praise him, you shouldn't have sat by me because I came to give him glory.
Mississippi Mass Choir, that song is entitled, If I Be Lifted Up, I Will Draw All Men Unto Me. And that scripture, the Bible says, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. We just have to praise God. That's our responsibility, is to praise God. The Bible says in Psalms 150, verse 6, let everything that has breath praise God. So that's our responsibility. We are not the judge, but we are to be able to do the introspective reflection, to be able to perpetually humble our own selves and pray and see God's face and turn from our respective wicked ways so that God can hear from us the sacrifices to him that exclusively are acceptable, which are a broken spirit and a contrite heart. That's all that we can give God. It's not by works, so no man can boast, but it's by our humility, our transparency, and our hope and trust and faith in who we believe in to do the work in and through our lives as we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony, loving out our lives unto death. Knowing that if God is for us, he's more than the whole world against us. The Bible says that no weapon formed against us will prosper, and every tongue that rises up against us in judgment, we have the authority to condemn. This is the heritage of us, the authentic servants of the Lord. And our righteousness is never of ourselves, but it's in the completed work of Jesus the Christ. Again, we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. God takes the weak things to confound the strong, the foolish things to confound the wise, and the lowly things of this world to bring shame to the proud, that no flesh will glory in the presence of God. Thanks be to God for the Holy Spirit that's working in us and through us, and to be able to woo us unto him, that ultimately transform us, that it's no longer I but Christ who lives by faith in us respectively. We're going to go to some more music by Norman Hudson. This song goes out to our sister Tina Lee, who is tuned in with us faithfully, and the song is entitled Emmanuel, meaning God is with us. That's good news to know that God is with us in every season of our life, through the ups, through the downs, through the difficult time, through the pain, through the questioning periods. He is with us in the lowest seasons of our life. He's carrying us in the seasons that we feel all alone. It's God who actually is carrying us through those seasons. Thanks be to God that he will never leave us.
Next time you're riding down,
he will never forsake us. He's with us always, even unto the end. Thank you, Father, for your Holy Spirit, that comforter, the teacher.
Let us
come, let us.
before Him.
Kneel down before Him.
Worship and adore Him.
Worship and adore Him.
Come on, say it again. Come.
Come.
Let us.
Come, let us adore Him.
Kneel down before Him.
Kneel down before Him.
In Your presence, Lord, worship.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We worship You.
Hallelujah.
We worship.
Yes, we worship You. Hallelujah. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord as God inhabits the praises of His people. This song also goes out to my sister Tina Lee, and the song is by the New Birth Total Praise Choir. Also want to dedicate this to our sister Anita Hamilton and to my own biological firstborn sister Benita Reddick and her husband Kevin and Malcolm and Mustafa, her sons, who are members of the New Birth Mission and Baptist Church in Atlanta, where the pastors are friend and brother Bishop Eddie Long. Christ in me. Only what we do for Christ will last. All right, Tina, get your praise on. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Oh, bless the Lord. It's the Christ in us.
Tonight.
Hallelujah. It's the Christ in me. It's the Christ in you. Hallelujah. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord as God inhabits the praises of his people. There's nothing like the presence of the Lord. Inside of me, we've got a treasure in an earthen vessel, so that the excellency is of God and not of us. Hallelujah! Glory, 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 glory. Inside of us, the great I am that I am, everything that we need, God is. Thanks be to God that he is the source. Every good and every perfect gift comes from God, the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness in turning in him. It's not even entered into the hearts or the minds of mankind. The good things that God's already prepared for those of us that love him. More music coming to you by Hezekiah Walker. This song's entitled More Than a Conqueror. Timonee Figueroa Caton featuring. And thanks be to God that we're not just conquerors. We don't just barely make it, but we are more than conquerors. God will do exceedingly abundantly, far above all that we could even ask or ever even.
Oh, I'm not just a conqueror. No, not just a conqueror. I'm not just a conqueror, but I'm more than a conqueror. The fight is fixed. I know I'll win. I won't give in, 'cause I'm more than a conqueror. My strong and my faith is long. I can't go wrong, 'cause I'm more than a conqueror.
I am not a conqueror.
I'm so much
Don't
more.
Don't call me a conqueror.
I'm not just a conqueror.
I am not a conqueror.
But I am
more than a conqueror.
And I know
I
we win.
I win.
Lord, to our beloved sister Maureen Hospitalis. God bless you, sis. We're more than conquerors. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord. We are more than conquerors. This song goes out to my sister Hospitalis, who is calling on the line. You're tuned into Healing Our Lands broadcast every Sunday night. We're on from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. This song goes out to Sister Hospitalis. Shirley sees that the song's entitled Nobody, featuring Jay Maul. 617-282-0655.
Welcome.
www.bostonpraiseradio.tv. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
If you're looking for a change in your life, tired of the same old misery and strife, I've got the answer if you want to know.
Nobody but Jesus can do it. I'm all in there.
Try to hide when you walk outside to cover up the bruises from a fight of last night. The man that you married done lost his mind.
Nobody but Jesus can do it.
You got three kids, two cars, and a home. One job ain't enough no more. You collect a ring and you telephone.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for Jesus. Nobody like Jesus. That song goes out to my sister Maureen Hospitalis from the Charles Street AME Church. Nobody by Shirley Caesar. You're tuned into Healing Lands Live Interactive Worldwide Broadcast here on the Boston Praise Radio and TV Network Live every Sunday night, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Monday, Thursday, and Friday concluding at 7 p.m. Tuesday and Wednesday concluding at 6 p.m. And we come back every Saturday for the Church of the Midnight Hour broadcast from 11 p.m. through to Sunday morning, 6 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, simulcasting on our local AM affiliate, WRCA 1330 AM, beginning at 12 midnight through till 6 a.m. This song goes out to my sister, Cindy Hester, and to the Grant family. The song is Say Yes by Michelle Williams, featuring Beyonce and Kelly Rowland. If Jesus says yes, nobody can say no. If God is for us, he's more than the whole world against us. We can rest in the confidence to know that God will never leave us and never forsake us. He's with us always, even unto the end. Hallelujah. If Jesus says yes, nobody can say no. He's the majority all by himself. And that song goes out to our sister Cindy Hester. God bless you, sis. We pray supernatural strength for you as she continues just to serve, working so diligently. We appreciate you, our sister. God bless you. We love you to life. You're tuned in to Healing Our Lands Live Interactive Broadcast here on the Boston Praise Radio ONTV Network. I'll be with you tonight for another hour. We're on every Sunday night, 7 p.m. till 9 p.m. This is the second Sunday of the month. So tonight I'm followed by our sister Elder Heidi Lewis Ivy, who hosts In My Father's House every second Sunday of the month, 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. That'll be followed by the Massachusetts Association of Minority Law Enforcement Officers, co-hosted by Dr. Willie Bradley and retired Deputy Superintendent Larry Van Zant. And so they'll be with us tonight, 10 p.m. through to 11 p.m. So stay with us right through to 11 p.m. tonight for our live programming here on the Boston Praise Radio and TV Network. More music coming to you by Tamala Man. This song's entitled I Can Only Imagine.
Can you only imagine? Can you imagine just standing before the King? Oh, I can only imagine what it would be like when I walk by your side. I could only imagine, yeah, what my eyes would see, when your face is before me. I can only imagine, I could only be surrounded by your glory. What will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak?
Forever worship you. I
only imagine what it'd be like to be in the presence of the Lord, to go from labor to reward, to lose these corruptible bodies and to be able to go from mortal to immortal. We can only imagine what it would be like to be in the presence of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, to be reconnected with all of our loved ones on the other side of eternity or other side of time in eternity. We can only imagine the good things that God's already prepared for us, those of us that love him, that are struggling every day in our lives, trusting God to be able to manifest himself in and through us day by day, not putting our confidence in our own flesh or any other flesh, but being confident in one source. That's none other than Jesus the Christ, God the Father, and the Holy Spirit, who will never leave us, who will never forsake us, who's with us always, even unto the end, who's all-powerful, who's all-knowing, and who knows the plan that he has for us. And that plan's a good plan. It is to give us a hope. It's to give us a future. It's to bring us to an expected end. And if God is for us, he's more than the whole world against us. I want to go to some more music. This song is entitled Angels by Donald Lawrence. Love this song. The God has dispatched supernatural beings, being angels, to stand guard around us, to do war on our behalf, to protect us, to lead us, and to guide us, even and to protect us from our own selves, our own carnal flesh that is at enmity, that's at opposition and opposed to the hostile. It's hostile to the divine nature. So I'm grateful for the Holy Spirit that is our comforter, that leads and guides us into all truth. Donald Lawrence featuring Carl Thomas. This song's entitled Angels.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, yo, Donald. I think we got the best of both worlds here, y'all.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Dean Lawrence.
Yeah.
Carl Thomas.
Yeah. Got me some angels.
Trendsetters, y'all.
Chi-town,
to your town,
we get down.
Yeah, that's right, bro.
break it down.
Got some angels, angels watching.
Yeah, they watch us. They hold us.
I've got some angels.
They keep us.
Oh, oh,
they protect us.
All night. All night.
All night.
Reading a Facebook post from Pastor Wall, giving a praise report on how God had angels to be able to stand guard, to protect him, to protect a woman, and to protect so many people who could have been hurt and or killed in a particular incident. This is a post that Pastor Wall put on Facebook, and I want to share it with you. It speaks to the angels that are watching over us. The quote says, a woman could have died today in Codman Square, unquote. I'm working in the basement of my church. I usually do not talk about my personal experiences, but today has to be an exception. On my way to pick up my lunch in Codman Square, I came upon a white man on top of a black woman beating and strangling her. Everybody else stood around and watched this man beat on this woman. I was concerned that if I had gotten hurt, that I would not be able to explain to Karen why I got involved. But out of pure reflex, I jumped into the situation and pulled out the man off the woman. The man tried to run away, but I had to stop him. So he and I began to go at it in the middle of the street in Codman Square. I pushed him back to the scene of the event, and he tried to get away from me. All of a sudden, the crowd that was just standing there decided that they were going to teach him a lesson, and they wanted to kill him. So now I was between perpetrator of the crime and over 50 people that wanted to rush him to beat and stomp him. Then from out of nowhere came a relative of the woman who was beaten and almost strangled to death, and he began to pursue this white man who was now standing on the sidewalk. I tried to persuade the relative to leave the man alone and that the police were on the way, but he began to slap my hands back. So now I'm between the assailant and the family member who wanted to beat him. And then said I then said to the family member that I'm a pastor. And once I said that, he quieted down and apologized for hitting me. Minutes later, the police arrived. The crowd was dispersed, and the police arrested the man that I had detained. I'm a little shaken up because I am experienced fear today because I did not know if I could stop the man from beating or strangling the woman, stop the crowd from wanting to beat and kill the white man, or stop the relative. He says, or of the woman who was beaten. He further goes on to say, but God prevailed and brought us all through this crazy experience. Now I'm back at the church preparing to go back out to the streets to pray with the group from the church. Wow. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for protecting our pastor, Bruce Wall. Thank you for the Christ in him that propelled him to be able to get involved. And thank God for the Holy Spirit that intervened, and that the people will reverence the Holy Spirit in this man of God. And this is what we're called to do, as the light and the salt of the earth. And this is a practical demonstration of the angels that we can't see that are standing guard around us, that are protecting us as we yield ourselves to be vessels to be light and salt in the earth. We'll experience the secret place of the Most High, that will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. We're going to go to some more music. This song's entitled Safe in His Arms. The safest place in the whole world is in the center of the perfect will of God. Even to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So we win either way. The Bible says to live is Christ. That's about a life of sacrifice. And to die is gain, because we go from labor to reward. As Christians, we are living out our faith. We are servants of the Most High. We're ambassadors of the kingdom of God. We're just passing through this place. This world is not our home. We don't love this world or the things of this world. Our kingdom is heaven, and we're bringing that kingdom on earth as it is in heaven, where there isn't racism and sexism and classism and phobias and disease. Those are all symptoms and consequence of sin and disobedience. So we know the safest place in the whole world is in the center of the perfect will of God. Darius Brooks presents the Reunion Choir, Safe in His Arms. Thank you. Hallelujah. Safe in his arms. Hallelujah. The safest place in the whole world is in the center of the perfect will of God. The Bible tells us in Romans 8 and 28, and we know that all things are working together for the good of us who love God and are called according to his purpose. Again, God's ways are on our ways, his thoughts on our thoughts, the high as the heavens are from the earth. But God will not forsake the work of his own hand. Daryl Coley coming to you for the good of them.
The race is not given. To the swift, nor to the strong, but to the one that endureth until the sometimes you'll have to walk all alone, but I know things will work out. Yes, they will, for the good of them.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. For the good of them, all things are working together for the good of us who love God and are the called according to his purpose. That's good news, beloved family, to know that all the plots and the schemes and all the tricks of people ultimately will come to naught. They can do every the ditches that people dig for us, they ultimately will fall in themselves. And we pray God's mercy as we use our power to empower, to edify, to build up, to encourage people to have an authentic, intimate relationship with Jesus the Christ, recognizing that he is the author, that from every good and perfect gift comes from, that there is no, the blessings of the Lord, they make it rich and they addeth no sorrow. I'm going to go to some more music. This song's entitled Teach Me by Antoine Stanley. Love this song. Pray that you're blessed by the sentiment of the song. 617-222-0685. www.bostonpraiseradio.tv. That everything that has breath, let's so praise much the Lord.
Last night. And I just knew that I was through. 'Cause when I walked out that door, I knew
I had failed your statues.
'Cause everything I did
flashed before my eyes.
My commitment to your will,
saying it's goodbyes,
moving hastily, yeah.
And never asked why.
Now this embarrassment's keeping me up at night.
Your grace is all I see,
reminding me
how good you've been to me.
Doesn't matter
what it takes, I need you with me.
Everything I see reminds me of you, and songs I hear
make me miss you more and more.
Lord, I've slipped out from under your covering, but I realize my mistakes. Will you hold me again? Protect me from myself. Everything I did, my commitment to your will,
saying it's goodbyes,
moving hastily, yeah. God, won't you give me another chance?
Your grace is all I see.
Your grace reminds me
how good you've been to me.
Doesn't matter.
So teach me how to love you.
teach me. Thanks be to God for the Holy Spirit. That's our teacher. That's our comforter. That will lead and guide us into all truth. Antoine Stanley from his project title cut, I Can Do Anything. One music coming to you by Sherry Jones Moffitt. This song's entitled The Grace of God. Going to follow that by a dedication to our sister Tina Lee by Stephanie Mills. The song's Power of Love. 617-282-0685. www.bostonpraiseradio.tv.
I still have peace. I still believe. I can conquer anything, and it's still by the grace of God. Still have hope. I've come through worse before, I have never walked alone. I've been kept by the grace of God.
I still believe.
I can conquer anything.
And it's still by the grace of God.
Still have hope.
Thanks be to God for the unmerited favor. That's what grace is, unmerited favor. Thanks be to God for his mercy, not getting what we deserve, and his unmerited favor on top of not giving us what we deserve. Thanks be to God for that unconditional agape love, that power of love. Stephanie Mills, Power of Love, dedicated to my sister Tina Lee. 617-282-0685, www.bostonpraiseradio.tv. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Of love, agape love that will never fail, love that is patient, love that's kind, love that does not envy, love that does not boast, love that's not proud, it's never rude, it's not selfish, it's not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrong, it does not delight in evil, but it does rejoice in truth, it always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, it always perseveres. Whether it be prophecies, they will fail, whether it be tongues, they will cease, whether we have knowledge, that will vanish away, as we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect, which is agape love, that which is in part passes away. More music coming to you by Tremaine Hawkins. This song is entitled Change, and love is an action word. It's a selfless, sacrificial thing that will cause us to change our carnal, selfish nature, to be able to be transformed, to have more of the character of our eternal Father manifested through Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, waiting, all creation's groaning and waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God, as we're transformed, as we're changed by the renewing of our mind. Tremaine Hawkins coming to you with a song entitled
A Change. A change has come over me. He changed my life, and now I'm free.
Jermaine is coming at this time.
Yeah.
Amen. A wonderful change has come over me, Tremaine Hawkins. And that change comes through our perpetual yes to God. As we submit to God, resist the devil, he's got to flee, and draw close to God, and God will draw close to us, and we'll experience the secret place of the Most High that will abide under the shadow. I want to dedicate this song to What Sent Unexpected, my very best friend who is in our instant chat room anonymously today, having some difficulty signing in under his username. But again, I want to thank those who are yet lifting him up in prayer. Please continue to keep the low Hamilton family in your prayer. My brother Sent Unexpected, aka Samuel Lowe, as he continues to serve his mother. The homegoing celebration of his brother-in-law Booney Moore was a beautiful, wonderful homegoing celebration, and the Holy Spirit was very present. So thank you all for your prayers. Thank you for your love. As we continue to pray for Mrs. Lowe, Mama Lowe, as she continues to heal from her surgery. And this song goes out to you, Ascension Expected, Alabaster Box by CC Wine. And 617-282-0685, www.bostonpraiseradio.tv. And I'm going to follow that by Help by Erica Campbell, also dedicated to Ascension Expected.
Yeah. be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and dry them?
You don't know the cost of the oil in our alabaster box. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. The sacrifices that are acceptable to God are a broken spirit and a contrite heart that he will not deny. My music coming to you by Erica Campbell. The song's entitled Help. 617-282-0685. www.bostonpraiseradio.tv.
SOS, I need you daily. Yeah. Can't lie and say the pain don't faze me. My God, who gon' help these babies?
I've been in the fire so long, I can't get burned no more. I thought you was putting out the flame, but it was rain from the storm. Thoughts over my head, making me stressed all day long. They won't let me rest, S on my chest. I ain't that strong. I need a lifeline right now. 911 won't do. My back's against the wall now. Done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail. I'm lost without your help. It's all about what you want. Your family used to be first, think getting worse in my home. My brother is hurt, we need a word, it's too far gone. I need a lifeline right now, 911 won't do. My back's against the wall now, done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail, I'm lost without you.
Can't tell my right from my left now. But my mama's crying cause my daddy's dying. He got pains all in his chest now. My daughter's having these nightmares. I might be wrong, but I'm right here, yeah. I'm trying to hold on when my hands hurt or the ropes out. Cause when life fights, it don't fight fair. So I'm leaning all on these ropes now. And I got hope, but it's low now. So I'm leaning all on these quotes now. Like never leave me, won't forsake me. If you don't help me, I don't make it.
Yes, God, we need your help. Never want to close out a broadcast without giving you an opportunity who may have never asked
the best help you can ever get, which is a relationship with Jesus the Christ, a friend that sticks closer than a brother. When mother and father forsake you, Jesus will still be there. He's all powerful. He's all knowing. He's every place, the past, the present, and the future, and he will never forsake us. We have a security with our relationship with Jesus the Christ, who uses his power to empower. The Bible says in Romans 10, 9 and 10, if you believe in your heart and you confess with your mouth that God has raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart, man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. There's no other name given to under heaven unto men by which we must be saved. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. We must repent of our sins to be forgiven. Are you ready to turn from your sin and by faith receive Christ into your life as your Savior and the Lord of your life? Say this prayer of commitment. Lord Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner. I believe that you died for my sin. Right now, I turn from my sin. I open the door of my heart and of my life, and I receive you as my Savior and the Lord of my life. Thank you for forgiving me and giving me eternal life and life more abundantly. Amen. It is so. Hallelujah. Celebrate God. Thank you, beloved family. Thank you, my sister Tina Lee. Thank you, my brother Ascension Expected. Thank you, our sister Maureen Hospitalis, our anonymous participants, and everybody tuned in. However you're tuned in, we appreciate your presence. God bless you. We're getting ready to transition to In My Father's House, hosted by our beloved sister, Elder Heidi Lewis Ivy. Thank you, beloved family. I'll see you on tomorrow. God.